डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी।
हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट, हैव अ नाइस डे। माई सेल्फ किरण पटेल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन स्कूल ऑफ कंप्यूटर साइंस ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी अहमदाबाद गुजरात। वेलकम इन अवर वीडियो लेक्चर्स फ्रॉम चैतन्य स्टूडियो ऑफ डॉक्टर बाबा साहेब आंबेडकर ओपन यूनिवर्सिटी। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ इन टूडेज सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद द कोर्स RDBMS, रिलेशनल डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम। इन दिस कोर्स वी विल लर्न अबाउट यूनिट 3 इन ब्लॉक 1। दिस यूनिट इज डिवाइडेड इंटू 2 पार्ट्स। दिस इज द फर्स्ट पार्ट ऑफ यूनिट 3। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, इन सेकेंड सेशन वी हैव बीन ऑलरेडी डिस्कस अबाउट द आर्किटेक्चर ऑफ DBMS, इन विच 3 लेवल्स ऑफ द डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम, दैट इज इंटरनल लेवल, कंसेप्चुअल लेवल एंड एक्सटर्नल लेवल, and also discuss about the different components of the DBMS also. Now, in today's session, we are going to start with the block 1. Unit 3 is the data model. The main objective of this unit is that to get the knowledge about evaluate the different data model and its mapping. This unit includes the different types of the data models like hierarchical data model, network data model, relational data model, entity relationship data model, and object oriented data model. Now we discuss about this model in details. First, we start with the introduction. The main objective of the database system is the data abstraction. What is data abstraction? We already discussed in previous lecture. What is data abstraction? The data abstraction is the view only necessary information to the user and to hide the storage and data organization detail from the user. So, the data abstraction is mainly used for the hiding the data and only necessary information is viewed. Now, the database model provides to achieve the data abstraction. Then, what is data model? Data model is the collection of the conceptual tools and set of the data structure for describing the data with the data types, data relationship, data semantics. Semantic means some rules to use in a DBMS. And consistency constraint. Consistency constraint means the condition to store the data in the database. Now, data model is decide the method for storing the data in the database. So, database model is actually used for the data relationship, rules and some constraint all over data, how to handle, how to store the data in a database is managed by the data model. There are different types of the data models we use for the storing the data in a database. Now, the data model is used to describe how the database's overall logical structure is represented. It can be very useful communication tools that provides the interaction between the database designer and application, programmer and end user. Now, it is a abstraction process that focus on the essential features of the application while ignoring the details which are not important. It consists of the data model theory and data model instance. So, data model consists both theory as well as instance. Means what? Data model theory means it is a formal description of how the data may be structured and how to access the data from the database. And data model instance means it is an applying the data model theory to create the practical data model instance for the particular application. So instance is used for practical, model is used in a practical way, and theory is described the overall structure. Now the process of applying the data model theory to create the data model instance is known as a data modeling. Now I think you know what is data model. Data model, what is a conceptual tools. Okay, it described all over thing how the data is stored in a database, in which format. Now the next is, we start with the hierarchical data model. Now what is hierarchical data model? Hierarchical data model was the first database management system model, which was developed by IBM in 1950s. So data are represented by the record. In this model, data is represented by the records, and relationship among the data is represented by the link. The data or record is organized into the tree structure. Basically, hierarchical data model is used the tree structure model. So what is tree structure? Here we can see in the figure, tree structure means where each record consists of the one parent record and many child record. So many child have only one parent. The hierarchical begins at the root or a parent node and then grows into the tree as a child node and added to the parent node. So hierarchical structure consists the levels or a segments. Level 0 is known as a root node or a parent node. At the level 1 is known as a child node. At first level, we can see here in the figure, parent node is in the level 0 and child node is level 1. So one parent and many child. Here hierarchical model supports one to many relationship. So here we see this model is based suitable to the represent one to many and many to one relationship only. Only two, one to many and many to one, not support the many to many. So in this model, each parent record can have a multiple child record related to it. But the limitation of this model is that one parent have a many child, means one to many relationship, and multiple child record can have only one parent record, means many to one relationship only. Hence, it is difficult to represent the many to many relationship using this model. So what is the limitation of hierarchical data model? The child have not multiple parents. The child have only single parents. So many to many relationship is not possible in this data model. Now we can see in the figure, the salesman record is a parent record. Here we see the S1 Harsal Vapi, S2 Parekh Surat, S3 Kamlesh Vapi is the salesman records. It is at level 0. So it is a parent records, which have a child records like item records. Here the S1 salesman have a child record, item 1 milk and item 2 cake. Item 1 and item 2 have a one parent record S1. And item 1 milk have a discount rupees 10. So it is item 1 is a parent for a discount amount 10 and child of a salesman 1. So the S1, S2, S3 is the main parent record at a level 0 and item 1, 2 and 3 is a level 1. It is a child of S1 and parent of discount amount. So it is hierarchical data model. Multiple child have single parent. Now here we see in merits of the hierarchical model. What do you mean by merits of hierarchical data model? It is the advantages. What is the advantages of hierarchical data model? First is the simplicity. It is a simple and easy to understand and implement because it is always one to many and many to one relationship. Now the second is the data integrity. The model promotes the data integrity as the child segment are automatically referenced to its parent segment. In this model, the parent and child relationship is always there between the layer. Now the next is efficiency. What do you mean by efficiency? The tree structure is very efficient. When the database contains the large amount of the data, when we work with the large amount data, then tree structure is better other than different structure. So here one to many relationship is maintained. So when we use or fetch or work with the large amount data, tree structure is efficient. Now the next is data sharing. What do you mean by data sharing? All the data are stored in a common root level. So the data sharing is easy because the parent record all the data maintain. So all the data fetch by the parent. So only parent record is the main source of the data. So data sharing is possible. Now what is the disadvantages or demerits of the hierarchical data model? The first one is the implementation complexity, because for the implementation it requires the knowledge of physical level of the data storage. We know about the physical level data storage. The database designer should have very good knowledge of the physical data storage. Then and then we implement this model. Now the next is implementation limitation. It can have only one to one and one to many relationship between the nodes. It is difficult to representing the many to many relationship. It is not permitted to have more than one parents. So implementation is limited because many to many relationship are not allowed here. Only one to many relationship and many to one relationship is provided. Now the next is inflexibility. What do you mean by inflexibility? Because it uses the tree structure using link. Thus, when a parent node is removed, then the child node is automatically removed. if there any insertion operation of the new relation or a segment, then it is very complex management task. And if the deletion of the segment will automatically delete all other segment below. So insertion operation is also difficult, and deletion operation is automatically delete the next level root. So it is inflexibility in tree structure to insert and delete operation. Now the next is database management problems. If any changes are made into the database structure, it becomes essential to change all the application programs that access the database. So any changes is reflect all the level. Now the next is no standards. There are no any specific standards or rules for how to implement the models. The next is navigation problem, because here in hierarchical model tree structure is used, so we use pointers. Pointer are used to connect the parents and child node and to traverse all the navigations between stored data. So pointer is difficult to handle all the navigation problems. Now the next data model is network data models. I think you know about hierarchical model and its limitation and disadvantages. Okay, now the next is the network data models. It is formalized by database task group in 1960s. The hierarchical model is extended in the network model. Some limitations in hierarchical models are overcome by the network model. So to overcome the disadvantages of hierarchical model, the network model is used. The network model was created to represent the complex data relationship more efficient than the hierarchical model to improve the database performance and the standards. So hierarchical model limitation is improved by the network data model. Now it is used the graph instead of the hierarchical tree structure. So network data model use the graph. In this model, it allows the many-to-many relations, that is many-to-many relationship is possible here. The record can have a multiple parents. It allows all the relationship like one-to-one, one-to-many, many-to-one and many-to-many relationship is allowed here. It supports all the relationship which is limited in a hierarchical model. Which relationship is limited? Many to many relationship are not possible in hierarchical data model, which is possible or present in a network data model. Now the next is network data model. This model has a three basic components such as record type, data items and links. The relationship is called the set. Here we can say the relationship as a set, and each set is have a at least two records type. Two records type which are owner record and member record. We can say owner record is a parent record and member record is a child record. Now the connection between the parent and child record is identified by using the link to which a set name is assigned. This link indicates access path and are implemented with the pointers. Now, in the network data model, here we give the some examples. In this figure, one parent have a multiple child, child 1 and child 2, and child 3 have a multiple parents like child 1 and child 2. So we can see here child 3 have a two parents, child 1 and child 2. In network model, it is possible. It allows the one child have a multiple parents. Now, same as in a figure 2, the distinctive network data model representation for a Bao University. The model represents the five records types. Which are the five record types? Here we see the Bao University record types is the School of Computer Science, after the School of Commerce, Library, Exam Department. Here the entity School of Computer Science have a one owners, Bao University. Similar that the School of Commerce have a same parents, Bao University. Library have a two parents, School of Computer Science and School of Commerce. Both are use the same library. In this model, each link between two records types represent the one to many relationship between them. Means one Bao University have a multiple department, that is one to many. But many child record have a one parent and library have a two parent. The School of Computer Science have a one parent Bao University and library have a two parent School of Computer Science and School of Commerce. Same as the exam department. Exam department is also a child records of the School of Computer Science and School of Commerce. So, we can say here one to many relationship also possible, many to one relationship is also possible, and many to many relationship is also possible. One child have a many parents. Here in the third example, salesman 1, salesman 2 and salesman 3. Each records, salesman record as well as discount amount records as well as item records are related both side. Salesman is connected with the discount amount and discount amount is related with the salesman. Same as discount amount is related with the item records. And item records is also related with the discount amount. Merit of the network data model. Which are the advantages of network data model? First is the simplicity. It is simple and easy to understand because this structure is very easy. Now facilitating more relationship types. It is able to represent one to many, many to one to one, many to many, all the relationships. It is able to handle many to many relationship as a member and child can have a multiple owner and parents. So, it is easy for all the relationship database. Now, next is the superior data access. And application can access the owner record and all the member record within the set or relationship. Hence, this model is better than the hierarchical for the data access and flexible. Now, the next is data integrity. Data integrity, it enforces the integrity and does not allow the member or a child to exist without the owner or parents. So, the child is not created without the parents. The School of Computer Science is not possible without the Bau University. So, it is maintain the data integrity. Now, the next is support for the DBMS. It includes the data definition language as well as the data manipulation language is possible in a DBMS. Next is the database standards. It also provides the standard. It is based on a universal standard formulated by the database task group, which is created network data model. Now, it is also improved by the ANSI. The next is demerit of the network model. First is the system complexity. Here, the network model are difficult to design and use properly. The navigational access mechanism access only one record at a time and hence makes the system implementation very complex. The knowledge of the internal data structure is required to take the advantages of this model. The next is the absence of the structural independence, because if changes are made to the database structure, all the sub schema description have to updated. So one level changes is effect on all the levels. There are two limitation main in the network data model. Now next is the relational data model. In relational data model, it is developed by or it is proposed by EF Codes. EF Codes proposed the relational data model. The relational data model represents how the data is stored in a relational database. What is the relationship between the data is described by the relational data model. Relational model use a collection of the tables to represent both the data and relationship among those data. Each table has a multiple columns and each column has a unique name. In single table have a multiple column, but in single table there are unique name of the column, no repeated column in a same table. Yes, if you create the another table, then two table have a same name of the column, but in a same table have a no same column name. Next is the database is a structure in a fixed format record of the several types. Each record type define a fixed number of the fields or attributes. The relational data models, which can be implemented using any RDBMS language like Oracle, SQL, MySQL, etc. Now the next is, first of all, we know the relational database model, we know the basic terminologies of the relational data model. The relational data model, first, what is relation? Relation we know as a table. Table is also called the relation. And in relation, there are tuple is used. So what is tuple? Tuple is known as a records or rows. What is domain? Domain, it contains a set of atomic values. Atomic means the unique values that an attributes can take. Now What is the attributes? Attributes is the known as a column or a field. We can say field or column, both attributes all are same. For example, in a student table, roll number is the attributes, name is the attribute, city is the attributes or a column name. Now, relation schema, it represents the relational name or a table name along with its attributes. Relational schema means it is overall design of the database or tables is called the relational schema. In a student table, roll number, name and city is the schema. What is relation instance? What is instance? Instance means the particular time in which the particular operation are performed. So, we see here set of tuples of the relation at a particular instance of the time is called the relation instance. It can change the whenever there is any operation, insertion operation, deletion, updation operation in a database. So, instance means we perform the particular operation at particular time. So, particular moment is called the instance. Now, next is student table. In student table, there are the three attributes, roll number, name and city. And here, the another table is the result table or relation. We can also table as a relation. So, in a student table, roll number, name and city is the column, and in a result table with the attributes roll number, marks of mathematics, English and science subject and percentage. These are the attributes of the result. Now, both the table have a common field roll number. The roll number column is not repeated in a student table and roll number is not repeated in a result table, but in a both table have a common field roll number. Using roll number attributes, both the table are associated with each other. So, it is a relational data model. Next terminologies is the degree. What is the degree? Degree means the number of attributes in the relation is known as a degree of the relation. Number of attributes in a last table we can see, for example, like a student table. So, in a student table, there are three columns, roll number, name and city. So, the degree of student table is 3. The next is cardinalities. What is cardinalities? The number of tuples in a relation is known as a cardinalities. In student table, there are 3 records. So, number of record means the cardinality. So, student table have a 3 records. The cardinalities of the student table is a 3. Now, what is null value? The value which is not known or unknown values is represented by the null value. It is represented by the blank, but blank is not allowed in the table. So, null value is represent what is a blank space or not known value. For example, in a student table, we don't know the city of particular student. So, we do not make the blank space, but we fill the null value in particular cells. Now, what is a relation key? It is used to identify the rows, uniquely identify the rows is called the key, or it is help to identify the table. There are the following types of the keys. First is the super key, candidate key, composite key, alternate key and primary key and foreign key. Now, the next is in relational data model, here we give one example. There are three tables: supplier, item, and shipment. Supplier table have some attributes like supplier number, supplier name, and city. And item table have some attributes: item number, item name, and price. Now the third relation is shipment. Shipment relationship have a supply number, item number, and quantity supplied. Here supplier and item table are related with the shipment table using the supply number and item number. So the supplier have a supplier number is a key attributes. Item table have a item number is a key attributes. And in both table, supplier number and item number is reference in the shipment table. And supplier number in supplier table is a primary key. Item number in item table is a primary key. And supplier number and item number in a shipment table is a foreign key. Now, next is the merit of the relational data model. First is the simple model. Relational model is a simple and easy to use in comparison of the other language model. The tabular view of storing and managing the data is easier way to fetching from the table or a database. Next is the structural independence. The structural independence, in this, the relational data model does not depend on the navigational data access, or hence the changes in a table structure do not affect the data access. Now the next is flexible and powerful query capabilities. The relational model is a more flexible than any other relational model present. The SQL is an English-like language, so it is easy to execute the required data operation and manipulation. It is provide very powerful and flexible and easy to use the query facilities. Now the next is the RDBMS support. In this, the availability of the powerful RDBMS isolation the end user from the physical level details and improve the execution and administrations easily. Now the accuracy, because the key features of the relational database is that they are strictly defined and well organized in a table format. So the data does not get the duplication, and it uses the primary key also for reducing the duplication. Now the demerits of the relational database model. First is the hardware overhead. What do you mean by hardware overhead? In this model, the model requires the faster processor along with the large capacity and high speed secondary storage devices to perform the assigned particular task. So it requires high speed processor and large memory. Now the next is poor design by the untrained professional, because it is managed by the untrained professional to develop the required queries. So the queries and reports written without the proper logical thinking result in a slower system and performance degradation. So here we need the trained person to handle the database. Now the next is a large database. It is not a very good for the large database, because it is not handled when the large amount of the data in a transactions. Now the next is high response time. Because of the complex structure, the response time for the queries is high. Now, at the end, today we have been discussed about the three data models in DBMS, that is hierarchical data model,
network data model and relational data model. In next session, we will learn about the remaining data model, that is entity relationship data model, object oriented data model, and comparison of all these data model. If you understand this session and getting the knowledge from this session, then please subscribe the Bao Gujarat channel. Thank you guys. Once again, thank you all.